Hello, kids and kids. This is Ruth from the Base Church, and today we're going to learn all about the armor of God, so stay tuned.
We're going to start off with a little experiment. Now you're going to need a couple of things. 2 lemons, 1 peeled and 1 unpeeled, and a glass of water just like 3/4 full. All right, so first of all, we're going to put the peeled lemon inside the water, and I want you to watch very carefully. Okay, so notice how it immediately sinks down to the bottom. All right, so now we're gonna take the lemon out and we're gonna throw in the unpeeled lemon. Okay, so notice how it immediately, almost instantly, just floats up to the top. The same goes with us. If we go into battle unprotected, we will immediately sink down to the bottom. But if we are protected with the armor of God, then we will float and we will stand firm against all works of the devil.
You take out your Bible now because we're going to do some reading. So in 2 Corinthians chapter 10, Paul says to his friends, the Corinthians, "We are human, but we do not fight like humans. Instead, we use God's power to fight the spiritual war in the right way." So we need to destroy false arguments and we need to destroy the devil and his evil schemes. But the right way to do it is to trust solely on God and to put on the whole full armor of God. I remember when I was younger, I used to ask my mom if I could go shopping with her. Not just so I could go look and go eye shopping, but so that I can try the clothes on and see, okay, this one fits me very well. I'm going to wear it and I'm going to make sure that I take care of it. Same goes with our armor. I'm not just going to let you go out there into battle not knowing what your armor is going to look like. Let's put on the full armor of God. We are going to start off with the helmet of salvation. Now, why do we need a helmet of salvation? We need a helmet to protect us against all the blows of the enemy that he might try to throw in lies and make us believe that we are a failure, we're not clever enough, we're not beautiful. All those are lies that the devil tries to tell us, and we end up believing them if we don't have the right gear to protect us from them. Next up, we have the breastplate of righteousness. Now, usually in movies, you see knights wearing these beautiful silver masculine breastplates, and those are there to protect your heart from the sharp arrows that the devil might try and throw at you. Now you need to protect your heart. We have the belt of truth, the shield of faith, and the sword of the spirit. Now we have the shield of faith. The Lord says he is our shield, and if we stand behind him, we will be safely protected from all the sharp arrows that the devil tries to throw at us. And then we have the sword of the spirit, because sometimes, even though we are not conquered, we need to also go out and conquer the devil. Next up, we have the shoes of the gospel of peace. And I just want you to do this for me. Quickly imagine a soldier running with no shoes on. Yeah, not very nice. Because there'll be thorns, there'll be lots of heat, there'll be blisters on his feet from running too much in the heat. It's just not good. So we need to get our feet prepared with the shoes of the gospel of peace so that we can go out, run the race that is set before us without growing tired because our feet are so sore, but also so that we are well prepared to go make disciples for Jesus. Put on the full armor of God. My mother and I wrote this straight from scripture earlier this week, and we hope that it'll be a blessing to you and also a reminder to put the full armor of God on before you go anywhere. This is how it goes. Put on the full armor of God with me.
Salvation, breastplate of righteousness,
breastplate of righteousness.
the video, remember to put on your full armor before going out into battle. Now, I've got a battle to fight. Feel free to join me, just put your armor on. Goodbye.
Bye.